Donald Trump fled to his Fox News safe space Wednesday for a meandering town hall with Sean Hannity, where he insisted he's not weird, told the audience they had to vote for him even if they don't like him, and complained about mosquitoes running around his head. For more on this, it's time for a closer look. Before Donald Trump came along and weirdified everything, a normal feature of campaign season was just standard retail politics. Shaking hands, knocking on doors, chatting in diners, that kind of thing. Like in a normal year, this visit by Tim Walz to a local shop in Pennsylvania on Wednesday to buy some treats would have been totally unremarkable.
We're a big fan of pumpkin.
We're pumpkin.
Pumpkin?
Yeah,
we're pumpkin
pumpkin
people.
All right, I think that's what we're gonna do.
I think get that one and that one, maybe.
All right. I said, look at me, I have no problem picking out donuts and things.
That's right. Walz joked that he's capable of picking out donuts like a normal human being. Why? Well, because of this now infamous debacle at a Georgia donut shop involving Trump's running mate and synthetic humanoid, J.D. Vance.
The zoo has come to town. Thank you for letting us come in here.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. I'm sorry, man. Okay, yeah. She doesn't want to be on film, guys, so just cut her out of anything. Appreciate that, man. I'm J.D. Vance. I'm running for vice president. Nice to see you.
Okay.
How long have you worked here?
I've been here since the beginning of July.
Okay.
But this year.
Okay, good. How about you, sir?
Almost 2 years.
Okay, good. Just everything. Yeah, I mean, a lot of glazed here, some sprinkle stuff, some of these cinnamon rolls, just whatever makes sense.
Holy. I had such secondhand embarrassment watching that I had to peer through my hands like it was a Saw movie. This dude orders donuts like his kidnapper is watching him from the car. I'll take some glaze, some jelly, whatever, makes sense. What do you mean, whatever makes sense? You're in a donut shop. You know what makes sense? Donuts. You know what doesn't make sense? Anything else. Let's see here, so many choices. Maybe some spaghetti? Is that crazy? No spaghetti? Did you run out? Oh, you never had it? Okay. Republicans can't beat the weird charges, so now they're trying to turn them back around on Democrats, but in doing so, they're only making things worse.
Women love masculinity, and women do not love Tim Walz. So that should just tell you about how masculine Tim Walz is. The other day, you saw him with a vanilla ice cream shake. Had a straw in it.
Oh.
Again, that tells you everything.
Does it? I don't understand. Please explain it to me, Jesse, girl's name. What are you saying? It's manlier to drink a milkshake without a straw and then walk around all day with a milkshake mustache? Having to lick your upper lip like a dog with peanut butter on its nose? I wasn't aware there was a masculine way to drink a milkshake. If there is, then someone should tell Donald Trump. And that's at a Yankees game. You drink a milkshake in the bleachers, there's a good chance someone's gonna scream, "Hey, up! You suck worse than this guy drinking his milkshake!" So Trump drank a milkshake with a straw, but surely no one who worked at Fox News would drink a milkshake with a straw. Well, if it isn't Trump and Bill O'Reilly, the double milk twins. This is what Trumpism and the MAGA movement have done to us. They've made the most banal, ordinary campaign traditions incredibly weird. But Trump does not like being called weird. He complained about it again last night on Fox News.
JD is not weird. He's a solid rock. I happen to be a very solid rock. We're not weird. We're other things, perhaps, but we're not weird. And then the fake news media picks it up. That was the word of the day. Weird, weird, weird. They're all going, but we're not weird guys. We're very solid people that want our country to be great again.
First of all, the opposite of weird isn't solid. It's normal. It's something you might know if you weren't so. And again, I wish there was a better word for this. Weird. Second, just blurting out we're not weird guys isn't doing the work you think it is. It wasn't even the question. Nobody said anything about weird. Can you imagine Trump as a contestant on Family Feud? Top 5 answers on the board. Name something you bring to a party. A parakeet, a Ziploc bag full of pills, a rubber dog turd. I'm not weird. Also, I love how unprompted he immediately just throws Vance under the bus. Mr. President, how would you solve inflation?
Well, you know, everyone's saying JD is a very weird man, you know. He's obsessed with childless women and he can't even order donuts without creeping everybody out. But, you know, I don't think he's weird. solid rock.
Trump is clearly very triggered, and you can tell when he's not feeling good about himself because that's when he reaches for his Fox News security blanket. Like a few weeks ago during the Democratic convention, when he was so desperate for the warmth and comfort of the Fox News safe space that he called in for a therapy session and wouldn't get off the phone, forcing the hosts to cut him off.
As far as RFK, I've had a great relationship with him over the years. I respect him. He respects me. I have no idea if he's going to endorse me. I know he's got a news conference. We happen to be in the same state. Arizona will be in the same state, but in quite different parts of the state. But it's possible we will be meeting tomorrow, and we'll be discussing it. He said, look, he was treated very unfairly by the Democrats. Yeah. He would have beaten Joe Biden in a Democrat primary. I have no doubt about it. And they made it absolutely impossible for him. They made it that you have to get 60-70% of the vote just to get in. And you
Mr.
know what?
President.
In the end, the Democrats did the same thing to Joe Biden. They threw Joe Biden out of the party.
And that's
they
why we saw a different night tonight.
They did to
Mr. President, thank you so much, sir, for the time.
Okay,
we appreciate that
much.
Live feedback.
Right. Stay right
thank
here.
You.
Live edition of Gutfeld is coming up.
It took both of them working together. He's a former president hoping to be the next president. They treated him like a customer on QVC who can't make up their mind.
I love the porcelain doll collection, but I really like the set of rotating service tray. Can you show me the line of quartz jewelry again? Ooh, what about the back massager? I'd love to see the pleather handbags. Do you still have the facial flex toning kit? Ma'am, I think we're going to have to move on to the next caller. No, wait, my children, don't talk to me anymore. All right, fine. The facial flex toning kit, was it? Oh, now I think I might want the toilet bowl nightlight.
And this isn't the first time this has happened. I can't even count the number of times he called into Fox and Friends and rambled for an hour while the host just sat there stone-faced like campers trying not to catch the attention of a passing bear. Next time, they should just let it go to voicemail and let the machine cut him off.
I have no idea if he's going to endorse me. I know he's got a news conference. We happen to be in the same state, Arizona.
You have reached your limit. Goodbye.
So on Wednesday, Trump once again threw himself in the friendly embrace of Fox News for a so-called town hall with Sean Hannity. That's where he insisted he wasn't weird. He also delivered a hopeful message of joy and optimism to all the voters in the audience.
You have no choice. You've got to vote for me. You've got to vote for me. You got to. Even if you don't like me. No, but even if you don't like me, you can sit there and say, I can't stand that guy, but there's no way I'm going to vote for her.
You might not like me. You might even hate me. You might despise me so much that the sound of my voice haunts your nightmares and the sight of my grotesque, leathery face fills you with an all-consuming incandescent rage that burns so deeply within the recesses of your soul that it fills you with every waking moment, thoughts of bitterness and contempt. And when you see my ghastly countenance on television, you howl in pain. You howl like Ahab grappling to the last with his nemesis, the whale. From hell's heart, I stab thee, you say. For hate's sake, I spit my last breath in thee. But still, you gotta vote for me. That can all be true, you gotta vote for me.
Trump is also still very much obsessed with Joe Biden, and he's clearly depressed about the fact that his political fortunes have changed so wildly since Biden dropped out, although he quickly got sidetracked by another urgent issue facing the nation, mosquitoes.
We had a good debate, and it was a fair debate, and he was down like 18 or 19 points after the debate. And I hate mosquitoes. I'm surprised. I didn't think we had. We don't like those mosquitoes running around. We want nothing to do with them, and we want nothing to do with bad politicians that hate our country, too.
Nice save. Good save, my man.
At least Mike Pence could make it through an entire debate without getting derailed by a fly. I mean, he didn't even know it was there. That fly landed and thought, finally, a dead person. And what do you mean they're running around? Mosquitoes are running around. He can't even talk about mosquitoes in a normal way.
You know, the worst thing about these mosquitoes running around is you can't hear their tiny footsteps. That's why we need to build a wall made of citronella. And we're gonna make the mosquitoes pay for it.
What a perfect microcosm of how self-centered Trump's campaign is. Everything relates back to whatever he's feeling in that exact moment. We don't want bad politicians, just like we don't want these bad mosquitoes buzzing around my head. The country is rumbling for change, just like my stomach is rumbling for a snack. JD, could you run out and get some donuts? Try not to freak anyone out this time, JD.
Yes, I shall procure the baked rings of dough. It is... It is interesting that they're called donuts, but rarely contain nuts. I find that humorous.
Get the out of here, JD. Why is he still here? This guy, I could have picked anybody.
A normal presidential candidate would be engaged in the standard retail politics of campaign season, out on the trail, trying to persuade voters. Instead, Trump is hiding in the bubble of right-wing media. He spends all of his time with guys like Hannity, Waters, and Vance, otherwise known by their nicknames.
Weird, weird, weird.
This has been A Closer Look.